Hey y'all, what's up?
Dan Foos here. Feeling a little loopy, as I'm sure you might be too, so I want to share a quick video on setting up Logic's new Live Loops and a MIDI controller to replicate the features of a looping pedal like this guy here, the old Boss RC20. This should work the same for any MIDI device, but today we're going to be controlling the Live Loops with our Korg microcontrol, but this will work on any MIDI device, any MIDI keyboard with any transport keys or any knobs or buttons. I know there's ways to accomplish this with Ableton and other software, but if you're used to the Logic universe, this is a really cool new feature. So let me show you how to get it set up. So I've opened up a new project and created some new audio tracks. And you'll see here there's a new button now on Logic 10.5, and that's going to open up our live looping situation. And so from there, we want to go to our controller assignments, and you'll see your controller there in the zone. This instance, it's Nano Control, but yours should show up. We want to make sure that the record setting, instead of saying record as a default parameter would be, that it says record into cell there on the commands. And then we want to do the same thing with our forward, which typically default parameter would be fast forward. So you have to cycle through all this long list of commands, which is there, it's all the way, maybe about 3/4 of the way down to the bottom. But we want to do a select next track instead of fast forward. So just make sure that that is the option there. And then we want to do the same thing with rewind, that the parameter default would probably be rewind, but we want to just turn that into select previous track. So what that's going to let us do is now with just the touch of a button on our MIDI controller, we can start a recording, and the quantization is all automatic based on the tempo information we gave it, and just we hit the record button again to stop it and automatically keep playing the loop, and then we can move on to put loops on top of that, layer them with the advance button, with our fast forward button that now we've made to the next track. So you can keep doing the same process, and then you can go back and forth between them. You can cue different ones. There's really no limit to, once you get in the weeds, of all the things you can do to control. You can add different effects and different automation. But this is just a little quick and dirty way to get up and running to turn your live loops into a looping pedal. Thanks.